गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन अबाउट द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ नर्नस्ट इक्वेशन, दैट इज ईएमएफ ऑफ दिस सेल एंड इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द कंडक्टेंस ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सॉल्यूशंस. सो बिफोर गोइंग टू दिस, लेट अस नो अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सॉल्यूशंस एंड इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक कंडक्टर्स. ओके, सो फर्स्ट लेट अस सी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंडक्टर्स. And electrolytic conductance. So before going to conductance of electrolytic solutions, I'm going to explain you electronic and electrolytic difference between electronic and electrolytic. Generally, electronic conductance and electrolytic conductors. So coming to here, these will conduct electricity. So these will conduct electricity through the flow of electrons. Electricity through the flow of what? Electrons. Coming to here, these will conduct electricity through the flow of movement of ions here. Means conduct electricity by movement of ions. Okay, so electrons means here you will be getting e minus, ions means you can get positive and negative ions here. So here electrons flow from positive end to negative and coming to here there will be charged species. Means these ions, this positive and negative ions only will transfer to the opposite, means charged ions. Charged species is nothing but here ions. So these ions move towards the oppositely charged electrons. Means what? For example, I have taken Zn plus and Cu2 plus. So when I have placed NaCl electrolyte, so what happens? So this Na plus will go to the Cu plus and Cl minus will come to the Zn plus. So means what happening? Already we are taking two types of electrodes. One is Zn plus 2, another one is Cu plus 2. So which is represented with a salt bridge. Okay, this two connected to a salt bridge. So what happens automatically? Here Na plus will come and here Cl minus. Means what? These ions, whatever ions is there here, so these ions automatically what happening? This charged species moving oppositely to the charged electrodes. Okay, so this is about this meaning. Next one here, when we here no chemical reactions takes place, no chemical reactions takes place. And transfer of matter does not takes place here. But coming to here, what happens here? Chemical change can takes place. Yes or no? So by seeing this only we can observe here some reaction is going to happen. So there will be represented in the chemical reaction when we have seen in the galvanic cell the half cell reactions. So chemical change takes place and also transfer of matter. Matter is nothing but what? Maybe ions, atoms, molecules can be takes place. Transfer of matter also takes place. So coming to here next, electrical conductance here. Whenever we take electrical conductance, it decreases. Electrical conductance means what here? The flow of electric current, means the substance which allow the electric current to pass through it. That one we call it as electrical conductance. But coming to here, the temperature increases, electrical conductance decreases. But coming to here, what happens? Here electrical conductance increases, temperature also increases. Means electrical conductance means what here? Flow of electricity. Flow of electricity through the substance. We call it as electrical conductance. Whenever electrical conductance increases, automatically what happens? The temperature decreases. If suppose this is increasing, this is decreasing. Coming to here, both electrical conductance increases and also temperature increases. So which type of things we are taking in the electronic conductors means here? In electronic conductors, we will be taking mainly metals, alloys, graphite. So these are the examples of the electronic conductors. But coming to here, coming to electrolytic conductance, what happens? These are examples means salts, liquids. Salts, liquids, acids and bases. So like these compounds we are going to take. So this is about electronic and electrolytic conductors. What is electronic conductance? Which will conduct electricity only through the electrons. But coming to here, it through the movement of ions. Means it can take chemical reactions also. Coming to here, it will not take chemical reactions. Okay. So coming to here, electrical conductance increases and temperature decreases. And coming to here, both will increase. So here examples will be metals, alloys, graphite. Coming to here, liquids, salts, acids, bases, these are the examples of the electrolytic conductance. So here the generally these things we'll be knowing. So coming to here, electronic conductors depends upon mainly two types. What happens here? Electronic conductors depends upon mainly two types. That is, first one, nature of the metal. Nature of the metal and its structure also. Next one, number of valence electrons. Per atom of the metal. Next one, temperature. Okay, so electronic conductance depends upon the nature of the metal and the structure and number of valence electrons. Valence electrons means what? The outermost electrons per atom. For example, if I have taken an atom, so there will be electrons and also nucleus. In this nucleus again, what happens? Neutrons and protons. So basing upon outermost means per atom means what? If you take one atom, this one electron, and if you take another, means each electron consists of valence electrons. Means valence electrons means outermost electrons, we say it as valence electrons. And also it depends upon the temperature. As we have spoken about temperature, here electronic conductor decreases the temperature. Why? Because here, because of the presence of the electrical conductance. Okay, electronic conductors decreases the temperature. It decreases temperature, it increases the electrical conductance. So this is the reason. So generally Here, conduct classification of materials. Generally, these materials are classified into three types, as we have spoken in the solutions, conductors, insulators, and also semiconductors, superconductors. So, coming to here, materials are classified into four types. What is first one? Conductors. Conductors means what? Which will produce current, yes or no? Means what? Metals are called as conductors. Metals means what? Metals means it is a good conductor of electricity, and also it is malleable and ductility, so it is having high tensile strength. Though these type of things we call it as metals, or also we can say it as conductors. So here, coming to here, metals and their alloys. Alloys means what? Mixture of metals. So we can say metals and their alloys have very large conductors, are called conductors. Okay, very large conductivity we say it as conductors. Here example we can take it as non-metals like carbon, graphite, some organic polymers also will produce the current. Okay, so carbon is a metal and graphite is a metal. So like this compounds means non-metals like carbon, so these produce conductors. Next one, coming to insulators. Insulators means what here? Which will not produce current. That when we call it as insulator, which is a bad conductor of electricity, we call it as insulators. So we can say that is not glass, ceramics have very low conductivity, we call it as insulators. Okay, so glass, if you take glass, it is a glass atoms means for windows you will be keeping, and also for birwas like that glass, yes or no? So those for cupboards, whatever glass you are keeping, it will not produce any current. Ceramics is nothing but you will be using fiber types cups, all means what we can say pingani. Those things, if we take that one all, we call it as ceramics. Okay, so these will have very poor conductivity, it will not produce any current also. So those type of things we call it as insulators. So coming to semiconductors, which is a intermediate between conductors and insulators, we call it as semiconductors here. So here substances like silicon doped with germanium and arsenide, yes or no? So which is having range almost 1 to 10 to the power 6 ohm centimeters, that when we call it as semiconductors. So these are important material which is used in electronic industries. So silicon, which is doped having arsenide, resistivity in the range 1 to 10 power 6 ohm centimeter are called semiconductors. So which is very important used in the electronic industry. Okay, so these type of things we call it as semiconductors. And superconductors. Superconductors means what here? Which will show zero resistance. Okay, we call it as superconductors. Generally it is having 0 to 15 Kelvin. So these will produce the 0 to 15K, means this resistance will show the superconductors. But coming to here, nowadays ceramic materials also will show yeah. Ceramic materials also show superconductors. What do you mean by ceramic materials? Pingani type cups, all we call it as ceramic materials. So this is about the electronic conductors. So what do you mean by electronic conductors? Which will flow through the electrons. It depends upon the nature of the metals and also valence electrons per atom, temperature. Okay. So these are the materials we are using, that is insulators, semiconductors, superconductors and also conductors. And coming to here, electrolytic conductors. Up to now we have spoken about only electronic conductors. When coming to electrolytic conductors, what happens, which do not conduct electric current in molten state or in solution, that one we call it as non-electro. For example, if you have taken sugar, glucose, urea, fructose, so when you pass current through these compounds, automatically what happens means this will not produce any current. If you take water, it can flow, but when you add sugar to it and when you add glucose to it, when you add urea, fructose, like these compounds, automatically what happens means it will not produce any current. So when you heat this compound also, it will not produce. That's when we call it as molten state. And when you take it in solution also, it is not producing any current. That those type of current conductors we call it as non-electrolytes. So these all are non-polar compounds. Okay, so it will be having strong electrolytes and also weak electrolytes. So now electrolytic conductors means which will flow current only through the ions. But coming to here, what happens, does not produce current in the molten or in solution, we call it as non-electrolytes. So example we can take here sugar. If you take sugar solution, it will not produce current. And the urea, glucose, so these type of things will not produce current. Why? Because these all are non-polar compounds. So that's why this will not produce current. So this is about electronic and electrolytic. Then which type of substances will produce current can be explained due to the conductivity of electrolytic solutions. Now let us enter into the conductivity of electronic solutions. So first of all, let us know the definition of resistance. Okay, so what do you mean by resistance? So resistance means what here? It is a passes of electric current. Okay, so generally it is used by measuring Wheatstone bridge. This resistance can be known by using Wheatstone bridge, as we have studied in the physics also. So now resistance will be measured in ohms. So electrolytic both metallic conductors and electrolytic conductors can be defined due to Ohm's law. Ohm's law means what? The potential difference across conductor is directly proportional to current. Okay, that one we call it as Ohm's law. So now coming to resistance is nothing but resistance is directly proportional to length and also inversely proportional to area of cross section. So what happens? It is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area of cross section. So this one we call it as resistance. Okay, so here R is directly proportional to L, length, and inversely proportional to area of cross section. So this one can be written as R is proportional to L by A, where R is equals to rho L by A. So where rho is indicates resistivity, or we can say specific resistance. Okay, so what do you mean by resistance? Resistance is nothing but directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to A, area of cross section. If we combine this one, L by A, R is proportional to. So to remove proportionality, we will be keeping proportional constant, that is rho, which is known as resistivity, or we can say specific resistance. So now let us enter into our topic, conductance. So where R is equals to ohm, units, this is the units of the ohm. According to Ohm's law, what do you mean by Ohm's law? The potential difference across conductor is directly proportional to current flowing through it. Okay, so this is about Ohm law. So means what happens, this is Ohm means what, E is directly proportional to I, where E equals to Ra. R is nothing but resistance of the conductor. So that's why we have taken R is equals to L by A, where rho indicates resistivity or specific resistance. So now if suppose if L is equals to 1 meter, A is equals to 1 meter square, then what happens if L is equals to 1 meter and A is equals to 1 meter square, automatically what happens? R is equals to rho. Okay, so this is about the resistivity, is the resistance of the conductor. Okay, so resistivity is equals to the resistance of the conductor of 1 meter length and 1 meter square area of the cross section. That is means what here? Conductor of 1 meter cube volume. So this is about resistance. Now coming to conductance. Conductance. So why I have told before conductance all these means, so without knowing these terms we can't enter into the conductance. So here the conductance is nothing but the reciprocal of resistance we call it as is known as what here? Conductance. So which is indicated, that is C is equals to 1 by R. R is what here? Resistance. Resistance means what? Which is indicated by the area of the cross section and length. So that is we call it as what here? This is the resistant. So when you substitute this value here, so what we'll get, how the current will flow through a conductor? C is equals to 1 rho L by A. So this can be written as C is equals to 1 by rho into A by L. Okay, so this is we are getting here. So this 1 by rho can be written as, how we can be written as 1 by rho? As K. Rho can be written as K C is equals to K into A by L. Okay, So generally this is the conductance. What is the conductance here? Reciprocal of resistance is known as conductance. So when you substitute R value, this one we are getting. So 1 by rho into A by L. Why? Because if A go upside, which is resistance, reciprocal. So 1 by rho we are taking is why? Because this is also a constant, specific conductance, specific resistance, resistivity. So we can take in K as a specific conductance constant. Where is known as conductivity, where here what I have told you, rho is equals to what I have told you, resistivity or specific resistivity. But coming to here, we are speaking about conductance. So that's why I have taken K into A by L. So this can be written as K is equals to continuation, K is equals to what we have written here, C is equals to K into A by L. So K is equals to what you will be getting, C into L by A. Okay, so this is from conductance we will be knowing the specific conductance. Okay, where specific conductance is equals to K, C is equals to conductance, where L by A we call it as cell constant here. L by A indicates what here? Cell constant. And its units will be centimeter inverse, or we can say meter inverse. Okay. So then what do you mean by specific conductance? What is the definition of the specific conductance? So the conductance of the electrolyte is the solution of volume of 1 meter cube, we can say, or we can say specific conductance as the conductance of the electrolyte in the solution of volume of 1 centimeter cube, we can say specific conductance. Okay, what do you mean by specific conductance here? The conductance of electrolyte in the solution of volume of 1 meter cube or 1 centimeter cube, we call it as specific conductance. Okay, so this is about specific conductance. So what do you mean by resistant? It is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area of cross section, we call it as resistance. Coming to conductance, what we have told, so reciprocal of resistance is known as conductance. So we call it as, from this we will be getting the specific conductance. The specific conductance means what? The conductance of the electrolyte of the solution is in volume of the 1 meter cube we can say, or 1 centimeter cube we can say. So this is about specific conductance, where L by A is cell constant, we will be saying. So now this electrolytic conductance, okay, this electrolytic conductance depends the conductivity of electrolytic solutions or electrolytic or ionic conductance. So depends upon the conductivity of ionic solutions, or we can say electrolytic solutions, depends upon certain factors. First one is nature of electrolyte. Okay, so nature of electrolytes, generally it consists of strong electrolytes and also weak electrolytes. Strong electrolyte means what? Which is completely ionized, means more ions we can say. Coming to here, it is incompletely ionized, which is having less ions. Okay, so these type of things, mainly this electrolytic solutions depends upon the two types, that is strong electrolytes and weak electrolytes. Here example, strong electrolytes we can take NaOH, HCl, NaCl. So these things all will come under the strong electrolytes. Coming to weak electrolytes, weak acids and bases means CH3, COOH, NH4OH. So these are the examples of the weak electrolytes. So this is about first factor. And coming to next one, size of the ion and solvation. So here, when size of the ion increases, automatically what happens means the migration of ions decreases and conductance what happens decreases. So coming to solvation also, if solvation increases, the conductance what happens decreases. Why? Because here this due to the migration means shifting of ions. Due to the presence of ions, solvation means what? Na. So here to the NaCl I am taking, which is replaced with water molecule. The NaCl is Cl minus, actually we should have, but it is replacing with H2O molecules. So what happening here, it is increasing, the solvation is increasing, and coming to Na plus ions, automatically the electrolytes what happening here, it is decreasing. Why? Because it is trapping. So automatically the size of the ion increases, solvation increases, the conductance what happens, electrolytic conductance decreases. Why? Because the migration of ions, migration means shifting of ions. And coming to next one, nature of the solvent and viscosity. So whatever solvent, for example I have taken solvent H2O liquid, so automatically what happens, whenever the solvent increases and also conductance decreases. Why? Because this is also due to the migration and moving of ions. We call it as nature of the solvent and viscosity. Okay, so next one we call it as concentration of electrolyte. So here concentration increases, conductance decreases, and also here last one, temperature. When temperature increases, conductance also increases. Why I have told in the electrolytic solutions, due to the intermolecular attractions of these two.